I'm here today because I want to tell you one of my life stories that happened 2010 and is still happening now. It was January 15th, 2010, and I was a freshman in high school, and I didn't go to school that day. I was very sick. I just had a bad headache and everything. And it was just a crummy day. And so earlier that morning, my dad went to see my grandpa. My mom was just doing her own stuff, and my sister was sleeping. And so it was just a boring day and everything. And later that day, at around 2:44, like 2:45, something like that, mom received a call from my grandpa saying, like, you have to come quick, come quick. Like, he's not breathing. And my mom was like, what are you talking about? My grandpa says, your husband's not breathing, you have to come quick. And so we get in the car, we go really quick to my grandpa's house in Las Gatas. And the first thing we see is my dad coming out on a stretcher and straight into an ambulance. So we're escorted. So my mom was like going all crazy and she was so sad. And so a cop offered us a ride to the hospital. And if you guys have ever been in a cop car, I hope you're not, you haven't, but it sucks riding in the back when you're my height. So like we thanked the officer for taking us and we were escorted right into this family room with like lions and animals everywhere. It was just a weird surrounding. And so a doctor comes in with a tissue box, right? And first thing that comes into mind is, this guy isn't gonna come in here and say, oh, he's fine, here's some tissues. That's not gonna happen. So I knew in the back of my head that he was gone. And sure enough, yes, the doctor said he had passed. And the day my life changed. It was just completely crazy. I mean, you see the movies and everything, and you're like, oh, that's sad. Yeah, that's sad. You never think it's going to happen to you. You never do. So, after months pass and like days go by, it really took a toll on me. And I struggled in school. I failed classes. I got D's. I just didn't know what to do. It was just a shock. And so, at the end of sophomore year, I was told that this is your last chance. If you mess up again, you're done. You will not graduate. So, this summer I took time off to find out who I was. Like, what do I want to do? And why am I here? I ate better, I lost weight, I wrote, because I found out I want to be a journalist. And my good friend Jason told me that writing is the best therapy. Like, you can write and it's just a great therapy for you. And I took that to heart and it worked. It was great. And so everything was going fine and I started to get on track, and I was like, yes, I can't wait till junior year. I can finally, like, become who I truly want to be. But life is funny that way, and one day I was watching a baseball game, just chilling, and I got a knock on a door, like, really bang, like, boom, 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 boom. And I'm just like, whatever. There's like this neighbor who always does that, just asking for stupid stuff. So I go, boom, 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 boom. I just keep hearing ring, 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 ring. I'm just like, oh, geez, I should check this out. So as I get up, I looked through my blindfolds, and I saw police lights. I answered the door, and it's a cop saying, "Sir, we need your assistance." And first I'm like, okay, they probably just need my help on something. So the minute I step out of the door, the police officer says, "We think it's your mother." And right there, just shocked completely. I was just like, oh no, what happened? So this is even weirder. As I'm walking down the street, the police officer says, "Your mom has been in a car accident down the road. Apparently, she was off going somewhere. She had a seizure, and she crashed into someone's house." So while I'm going down there, it's this complete shock. I see someone's house just obliterated on the side of their house. I see her car just gone. And I see her, I see the cops and the firemen trying to take her out. And luckily, she was fine. She just had scratches on her. She didn't know where she was. But still, that was just crazy. I mean, right when I think I'm getting back on track, this happens. But again, luckily she was fine. And she's here today right there. There's my dad right up there. So, like, when I went to advisory for Ms. Brazil a couple months ago, she told us that, like, you have to write down the wish you want, and maybe it'll come true. So I didn't think it would happen, but I just prayed that maybe it will. So when I got the star, I wrote down that I wanted to share my story for people to hear. So maybe help motivate them, inspire them. I just know that there is hope out there. And there is. I know there are people in here that have gone through this, and it sucks. But it also sucks to say that people in here will go through it. And all you need is hope, because you will be in a dark place when it happens. That's just the way it goes. And if you find that hope, you will come out of the darkness and you will see the light. Because, trust me, it sucks to lose a loved one. And all I can say is just hope and pray that you'll be all right and try to find the strength to overcome it. So, I thank you guys for listening, and I hope you guys got something from this.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. When you get what you want, but not what you need.